Welcome back to All Things with Allah. I am Allah, and we are at the Macaron Tea Room kitchen today, and we are working on our Ukrainian cheese spread to make our Ukrainian cheese, ooh, it fell, our Ukrainian cheese sandwiches. So when customers order just sandwiches, this is how I like to display them. And I'm going to walk you through which bread we use, how to make the spread, what you're going to need, all that good stuff, and a fun story of how this got its name. So here we go. Let's make some sandwiches. Let's get started. So I wanted to show you what you guys are going to need. So a grater, the garlic mayonnaise spread, and I will link underneath our Ukrainian, our egg salad sandwiches, and on there I explain how I make this. So you're going to need this. You will need a potato masher, some pepper, these things, properly cooked eggs. I will also link on my video on how I show you the great tips on cooking eggs perfectly every time. Laughing cow cheese. She's laughing, so I have to smile at least, right? And then we have just, utensils. If you're new to my channel and this is the first time you're watching, this is your first video that you're watching, I eyeball everything when I bake and when I cook. Not, okay, I won't say every recipe, but a lot of the recipes. So when I'm here with you guys making these recipes, we're making the recipe together. I know what it's supposed to look like. I know how it's supposed to taste. I know how it's supposed to smell. But I don't know exactly how many is it? A half a teaspoon, if it's 1 teaspoon. But so far, I've done a few recipes. You can go back to the other videos, and every single one of them are perfect. So it's the same like it's supposed to be. So let's get started. First thing you're gonna do is peel your eggs. I, at the same time, did one of my cow cheese. So the cow cheese that I have here is the garlic and herb, but you can totally use plain, or there's like light, I believe. I've used plain. I like the plain, and then we enjoy, most of the time we do use the garlic herb, but we go back and forth, and honestly, there's no big, that much of a big difference. But what I wanted to tell you, so when 6 years ago, when we started the tea room, we wanted to have some kind of sandwich that's like, oh, I forget that cheese spread that a lot of tea rooms have. I'm sure you know what it's called. I forget what it's called. And my mom, when we were little, she would make this sandwich and we would put it on bread, spread it, and put fresh tomatoes on top. So good. And ever since we were little, she always made that sandwich. So I was telling my sister, because me and my sister were putting the menu together, I said, hey, let's put mom's cheese spread on the menu. And we couldn't think of the name, and I didn't want to like give out too much information on the recipe. So I didn't want to call it, laughing cow cheese or spread or anything like that. So we decided, hey, mom came up with it. She must have brought it with us from Ukraine. She must have did it in Ukraine. I don't remember. I was 7, by the way, when I immigrated here with my family. So she, yes, I'm from Ukraine. I came here in 89. So she made these sandwiches. So I assumed she brought them from Ukraine. She made them in Ukraine. Not registering in my head, like there's no laughing cow in Ukraine. I mean, maybe there is, I don't know, but she didn't. So we had a customer, an older customer, Ukrainian older customer. She said, oh my goodness, this is the Ukrainian cheese spread. It's so good. It's so good. What kind of Ukrainian cheese do you use? And she was very into, or I don't know what that word is. Like she was persistent. Like she wanted to know what this was. And I'm like, so I told her, and she's like, that's not Ukraine. I was like, oh, okay. So then, I don't know why I didn't ask my mom before. But then I asked my mom, and she's like, no, she's like, I just came up with it here. Well, she's Ukrainian, so we still continue to call it Ukrainian cheese spread. So that's my little funny story of how our Ukrainian cheese spread got its story, got its name, I should say. Because I thought my mom brought the recipe with her from Ukraine, and she didn't. But she's Ukrainian, so we're gonna stick it to it. We're gonna stick to it. We got all our cheese in here. Again, it doesn't really matter if you're using the regular or the garlic. What I did find is if you use the garlic, it's not as dark. As you can see, this one's a bit darker, but if you're using the regular one, it's not as dark. The garlic in the cheese makes it darker. Totally fine. We are gonna grade. So we had two packages of three packages. Sorry, I knew I was that looked off a little bit. Again, we make everything for the tea room. And right now I'm prepping for our Saturday rush, which is our largest rush. We usually have around 60 guests come through the door for our high tea, afternoon tea. So we do a lot. I wanted to share with you the portion size exactly how we do it. Now, if you want to play with it, make it smaller, make it less, totally do that. I just want to show you how we do it exactly here so you have the exact recipe. We make it fresh every few days. But our Saturday is our biggest one. So usually I make it Friday and then I'll make it again on Wednesday. And we're open Tuesday through Saturday. All right. Also, when you're doing this, it's good to have the cheese cold. It's much easier to get it out of these little foil doodads. But be careful that you don't get foil left in there. I've had that happen where I'm not paying attention and rushing and notice there's foil in there. Always have a wet towel next to you. If you guys don't have like these microfiber towels, get some. They're the best. Easy to wash. And they're just so great because I hate towels that leave like fuzzy stuff. And these don't do that. I got these at Costco. Okay. Right into our three packages of cow cheese, we're gonna grade five cooked eggs. Your perfectly beautiful cooked eggs, none of that gray stuff. I will link to you below my videos of how to cook eggs and how to make this garlic spread. You're using the small grater, not this funky bumpy one, not the large one. We use this for our carrot bruschetta, but the small one. Okay. Clean up, clean up. Keep it clean. We're gonna do a half teaspoon of pepper. Okay, less than half, because that looks really big. So it's not completely full. Can you see? Almost, but not. This is the pepper. So less than half a teaspoon. And then we're gonna do our a third of a cup. This looks, you guys, I'm eyeballing and I see this is what it looks like. We're gonna do a third of a cup of this garlic mayonnaise. And then a third of a cup of regular mayonnaise. If you were using just plain, what is that called? Cow cheese, then you can use two thirds. No, I'm saying it wrong. Okay. I'll have to do the math. I'll write it in the description on what two of these, one third, which you would think would be two thirds, right? I don't know. I know, I should know. What I was trying to say is I'm a little bit embarrassed that I don't know that, but that's all right. I'll get over it. Because the cow cheese has garlic in it, the one I bought, I'm using a little bit of the garlic spread and a little bit of regular mayonnaise. If you were using plain garlic or a plain cow cheese, then just use only the garlic mayonnaise. And now we just mush it like you do for mashed potatoes. I am not embarrassed by my age, so I'm 42 years old. I graduated high school when I was in 99. That was a long time ago that I did math. And I normally don't do like recipes and stuff. I just either follow a recipe, 95% of the time I'll change it, and the others I eyeball it. So I don't know what to tell you guys. Two times one third. Two thirds, right? But if you think about it should be 2/6 because it's if you add it, but I'm sure that's not right. Oh, my math teacher right now is very proud of me. I still remember her name too, Mrs. Klima. That was my middle school math teacher. High school, I don't remember. I think because I had like three of them, so. And then in middle school, I had her for 2 years. Easy peasy. And that's your Ukrainian cheese spread. Okay, move over, make some room for your friend. There you go. Just gonna mix it a little bit more. That's it. That's what that looks like. And I'm looking around for my bread and I don't see it. So I gotta go get my bread. Uno segundo. I think it's in the back. Thanks for being patient. I'm back. Okay. This is the bread that we use. I get it at Costco. I'm sure Walmart has them, any other grocery store has them. You don't have to use this bread, but this is the bread we use. French baguette, also a great alternative. All right, let's put some sandwiches together and then I'll show you exactly how I spread it and how I cut it.
All right, bread is out of the bag and we are gonna put our Ukrainian cheese on it. I would say you're putting on at least 2 good tablespoons. And I mean like good tablespoons. So you want to put quite a lot on there because it is very yummy and you want to make sure you taste it. Make sure you're going from edge to edge so that it's nice and even when you guys cut it. We're gonna cover it with the other slice, and then when we're cutting the edges, make sure that you are using a serrated knife. I have found that it's the best kind of knife to make the cuts very nice and even, and you're not smooshing and squishing the bread. Once we cut off all the edges, we're going to cut it down right in the center, and then we are going to go from edge to edge. This particular knife I got from IKEA, and I absolutely love it. And here we go. Beautiful little triangles with the delicious Ukrainian cheese spread in there. Thanks for watching. And don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. I really appreciate you being here, and I hope you guys have a blessed day.